Hi friends, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to share how I would learn data science if I were to start all over again. A lot of you have been requesting this video, so I thought I would share my thoughts and things that I've learned that I now, if I get to redo, what I would do differently. If you have watched some of my previous videos, you know that I am a self-taught data scientist. I actually did not go to school to study data science. My background is in business, and I had to make that transition through self-teaching, through online courses, but there were definitely mistakes that I made. And now looking back, let's say if I were to do it all over again, this is how I would do it. And if you find information in today's video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, and everything else in between. So the first thing I would do, which I think I made a mistake on, is I just jumped in. I heard the word data science, the sexiest job, and I just jumped in. Like, data science is a huge job family. There are dozens of jobs within the data science. And honestly, I had no idea about this. And to me, the job family that was thrown at me, or job family that I was introduced to, was a data scientist generalist role. So when I jumped into learning data science, that was the role I targeted. But eventually I realized that there's actually a lot more options that I could have considered if I were to start all over again. For you who are just trying to figure out, who want to get into data science and you're just trying to figure out your path, what I would want you to do is study the data science field, start understanding what are the different job families within it, what it takes, what is the type of work that you would need to do to basically, what are the type of work that you will be doing as in that role, and then align it to your interests and your skill set. Figure out where you're gonna be good at and figure out where you're gonna enjoy working, and then follow that path. So that's the number one thing that I would say is research. Spend a lot of time studying, online reading, talking to people who already work in that role to get a better idea. So that's number one thing that I would do instead of jumping into one role that I heard that I have heard of. I would actually take a step back and try to see, like, within data science, what are my options and what do I need to do to go from point A to point B? But you would need to do a lot of research to figure out that point B before you start creating a plan. The second step I would suggest is, let's say you have picked data scientist generalist as your role that you want to target. So the second step that I would suggest, we're not done researching yet, we're going to do a lot more research. So look at the data scientist generalist role and read the job descriptions at different companies. So study the role at different companies. And let's say if you have an ideal company, study the role, study the job description for that role, and try to understand what are the requirements that you would need to kind of check to be able to qualify for that role. And also, a lot of people don't do this. Go on LinkedIn. If you have already that role, that job description, go on LinkedIn and study the profiles of people who are already working in that role, because that's going to give you a really good idea what are the things that that person did that you need to do to basically be able to be qualified per se. So yeah, that's like my second thing that I wish I had done. I actually did it later on, but I think that was too late. So if I were to start all over again, I will study the data science job family. I would also, once I've narrowed down the role that I want to focus on, I would study the role and read the job description at different companies. The third thing I would do is, there's a lot of advice that is out there that tells you to start with coding. I would not do that. I would actually, let's say if I pick data scientist generalist as my role, I would not pick coding as the first thing I need to learn. I would pick the theoretical concepts when it comes to statistics, when it comes to machine learning, when it comes to business understanding, and I would have a very solid understanding of all those things before I actually get to the coding part. I think learning to code is great, but that's, just remember that coding is just a way, is a tool to apply data science. It's not the data science itself. There's a lot of people who know Python, but they are not data scientists. So think of language, the picking the coding language, as a tool to apply data science. But you need to understand data science conceptually, understand the fundamentals before you get to the next step. Because if you jump into coding, the first thing, you are actually skipping a step and you're jumping into the coding piece of it. Where I would start is statistics, like get really, really good at statistics, because no matter which role you are in, you are statistics is part of basically all the roles within data science. So you cannot go wrong learning statistics. And if you need more detail on this topic, like I did one of the videos where I talked about why learning statistics is very important as the first step to learning data science, I would recommend you to watch that video. I have done a detailed video on this. If you haven't watched it, I suggest you to go watch that video where I talk about why statistics, learning statistics is important for data science. Let's say you have done learning the theoreticals. You understand data science conceptually very, very well. Now is the time to apply the concept that you learned on data that you're working with. So here, I would suggest to start learning to code. So see the steps that we did. So step number one was researching the job family because data science is a huge umbrella. Second, researching the role once you have narrowed it down. Third, getting really good at the concepts and understanding the fundamentals and theoretics. And then the fourth step is when you actually start doing the coding, start learning the coding. And for coding languages, I don't think there is any wrong choices. But for me, from my personal experience, I actually started with SQL and R. And looking back, I wish I had started with SQL and Python. I also did a video on this, on which language I would choose, Python versus R. I would definitely choose Python, and you can watch this video where I go into a lot more detail and give real world examples of why I picked Python over R. But I would say, like, if you are trying to decide, like, Python is a good choice, so pick SQL, Python. SQL is a must, no matter which role you are in the data science. I think a lot of the people have to make a decision. Do you want to learn Python or do you want to learn R? If you have the option to choose, I would suggest picking SQL and Python. Now, that being said, SQL and R is also pretty good. So I don't think any of these choices are wrong. It all comes down to personal preference. And remember, if you have done the research in step two, where you understood the role and you understood the job requirement, that will actually help you decide what language you need to pick and what area you need to focus on. That's why researching is a very, very important piece of creating your plan to learn data science. All right, so now let's say you have done your groundwork, you have done the learning fundamentals as well as coding. Now it's time to do the projects. So now it's time to take everything you learn and turn it into a project. And Kaggle is actually a great place to start, where you can look at other people's projects and you can look at what other people have done. And there's a lot of data available on Kaggle. So that's a great place to start to kind of figure out how you can build your project portfolio and then build your project portfolio. I'm planning to do another detailed video in terms of like how to build your portfolio, but just know that if you have done the research on step two, you actually kind of know what kind of project you need to do to be able to stand out for that role. I'm recommending that you get an idea of what type of projects will help you qualify for that role or for those roles that you are targeting. So that's where you need to do another connection between the project work that you do and the project, the job requirement and people and the projects that other people have worked on who currently work in those roles. So do a lot of projects, build your data science project portfolio where you are able to show what you know and you're able to apply the concepts that you learn, the theoreticals, as well as you're able to do the hands-on work to show that you actually know what you're doing. And remember, when you are trying to work on those projects, remember that start with the problem and end with the impact. And whatever you do in the middle, make sure to kind of highlight that as well. But I see a lot of people miss the problem and the impact part, and they only focus on, let's say if you build a decision tree, they will be talking about like, I build a decision tree to do this. But why did you do that? What was the impact of it? So make sure like to follow that framework, start with the problem and end with the impact. And in the middle, you can talk about like how you solve that problem to get to the impact part. So those were the first five things that I would do if I were to learn data science again. So let's say you have done that. There is one last step that I think a lot of people miss, because a lot of people start thinking that you have done the work, and I made the same mistake, that you done the study, you did the projects, and you build a portfolio, now you should get the job. That's actually not true. You need to now prepare for the interview. I'm sure you have heard that interviews is a completely different monster in itself, where it doesn't really reflect like I'm gonna say this, it doesn't really reflect how well you know. It actually reflects how well you know in a limited time frame under in a pressure setting. So let me say that again. The interview process is trying to see how much you know in a limited time frame, where you're given a problem and you're able to solve in a limited time frame under in a pressure setting. That's a completely different thing from the day-to-day work to the interview. And I know that's like a completely different topic. This is a different topic for another video. But just know that just doing your data projects, doing the learning is not enough to actually land the job. Now you have to put in the work to start interview preparing. Do the hands-on coding prep where you are solving problems in a limited time frame, and do a lot of mock interviews. Brush up on your fundamentals, the things that you learn, brush up on that. Do a lot of mock interviews with your friends and try to see where you are good at and where you can improve, and then iterate on that. All right, so those were the 6 steps that I would do if I were to start learning data science again. So let me know in comments what has been your process. For those of you who did do the self-teaching, who did follow the self-teaching route, what was your process? Do any of these steps surprise you or resonate with you? Let me know in the comments. And with that, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a beautiful day. I'll talk to you later. Bye.